Good morning, everybody. I am Deepak Phatak, greeting you from IIT Bombay. Welcome to this IST workshop on basic electronics being conducted by Professor Dinesh Sharma and my other colleagues from the Department of Electrical Engineering. We will have a very brief inaugural function in which I will act as your master of ceremony shortly. Let me begin by welcoming the respected faculty members and the chief guest of the function today, Professor Kannan Moudgalya, who is coordinator for all MHRD national mission projects at IIT Bombay. May I invite Professor Kannan Moudgalya here, please? Thank you, Professor, for joining us. May I request Professor Dinesh Sharma? Thank you, Dinesh. Professor John. Thank you very much. Professor Patil. Not here. Professor Patil couldn't join us today, but of course, he will be meeting you very often during this course. Ms. Madhumita. Thank you very much for coming. Before I request Professor Kannan to say a few words, let me just tell you that in the series of IST workshops that we have been conducting in this mode, we first began with some pilot workshops and carried on. Initially, we conducted courses in computer science, computer programming, and database management systems. Just this year, almost a month ago, we forayed into the first non-computer science course for this workshop, which was on thermodynamics and was conducted by my colleague, Professor Guy Tonde, and his colleagues from Mechanical Engineering Department. And now we have another extremely important core course in engineering in basic electronics being conducted by Professor Dinesh Sharma and his colleagues. When I had started this mission project, the ambition was to have more than 1,000 teachers in a workshop like this to address the issues of scale of large-scale faculty members who wish to attend such workshops and benefit from them. We use a blended mode of instructions here. The lectures will be delivered from IIT Bombay, whereas the lab assignments and tutorials will be conducted at remote centers under the supervision of expert faculty members who themselves have participated in a one-week preparatory program physically at IIT Bombay. What is so special about this course is this course has recorded the highest ever attendance so far. When we began, we had workshop attendees in the range of 700 to 800. The largest attended course so far was the Database Management Systems course taken by Professor Sudarshan, and it had about 1,049 or so attendees. I am very glad to record that this course has more than 1,300 teachers attending from all over the country. This is the largest ever attendance. As I had proudly claimed that teachers' empowerment on this scale has never known to have taken place anywhere else in the world. We were the first country to attempt it successfully. And now I am glad to add further to that record that never before 1,300 teachers assembling at multiple places have benefited from a two-week workshop of this kind. So my compliments and welcome to this workshop. Without further ado, let me request our chief guest, Professor Kannan Moudgalya, to make his brief remarks.
Good morning. On behalf of the National Mission on Education through ICT, which is sponsoring this event, I would like to invite you all to this course. So, first about myself, although I started as a chemical engineer out of the love for electrical engineering, I went and got another master's degree, and I do more work. My work can be more classified as electrical engineering work. By the way, although you may have several departments, electrical, electronics, telecom separately, here all of them come under electrical engineering. So when I say electrical engineering, it covers all the fields, including microelectronics. What I want to say a brief, in brief, about the National Mission on Education through ICT. This is started to raise the levels of education in the country, including the colleges, private colleges, funded, aided colleges, unaided colleges, and so on. The total outlay on this mission is 4,600 crore, and in fact the first phase of that is going to end by the end of this financial year. Hopefully this will continue in the next plan period also. I will not spend too much time on that. I have already created a video tutorial, and it is available at spoken-tutorial.org/NMEICT.intro. So already available, it's about 8-minute video. It explains that essentially the mission has three components. One is to create content, the second one is to give bandwidth, third one is to give low cost access device. You would have heard a lot about this low cost access device, and we expect the first lot of 1000 to arrive very soon, and it is going to be available at a cost of ₹2200. Now about this, I will just say a few words about the content generation. You would know about NPTEL. NPTEL is the flagship project of this mission. As a part of this mission content generation, IIT Bombay also created a lot of courses live, in fact following the footsteps of what Professor Fatak started here, in fact in this very room where I am talking from. And I am glad to say that we transmitted almost 5000 hours of lectures, and about half of them happened to come from in electrical engineering. In fact towards the end I would say that electrical engineering courses exceeded computer science courses. So so that makes me, you know, it's an appropriate remark for this talk. The the other important thing that I want to talk about, mention here as a part of this national mission projects, is the virtual lab. Because the question is, if you just make available only the theory courses, it doesn't complete training. So what do we do? So the government thought that virtual labs is possibly one option, and I'm glad to say that you will see, you will get exposed to virtual labs in the EE area through this course. So finally, I would like to point out some other projects that are being done as a part of this mission at IIT Bombay. One of the projects is this 1000 teacher training program. So I am glad to say that we will have to rename the title of this project to 1300 teacher training program. Okay, that is the very first one. So you will get, I don't have to say anything more than that. I want to talk about, I want to mention briefly the other projects that are happening here, and many of these, in fact all the projects do invite your participation, active participation. In fact you could all become partners in this. One of the things that Professor Fatak is planning in this 1000 teacher training program itself is to have lectures delivered by experts from any college, so long as that person is an expert, the affiliation actually doesn't matter. So this project will go in that direction in the near future. So I would like to emphasize that we invite your participation. In fact, would like you to become partners in our endeavor. The first thing that I would like to mention, one of the projects that happening here is Scilab. Scilab is an excellent replacement for MATLAB. I know that most of you are using MATLAB in your curriculum. I just want to point out that most of your students will not have access to MATLAB when they leave your college. Okay, whether they go to industry or whether they start their own private enterprise, whatever it may be, they will not have access to MATLAB because it is extremely expensive. So we have been promoting an equivalent open source software called Scilab. So the website for that is scilab.in. In fact, one of the coordinators of this project is Professor Madhu Belur of Electrical Engineering at IIT Bombay. So we are under this, we have a project called Textbook Companion. This project involves creating code for worked-out examples of standard textbooks. And I'm glad to say that in this summer alone, IIT Bombay is hosting 50 students from around the country. Some of these students, in fact, many of the students could be from your colleges. And then very soon we will have about 100 textbooks, Scilab code for 100 textbooks in our in this website. And this is something that is participatory, collaborative, and good students from your college can help create this national resource. The second thing that I want to talk about in Scilab is, one is Textbook Companion. The other one is promoting this as a tool for hardware interfacing. Okay. So, for example, we have been able to connect through Scilab almost 150 A2D cards, digital I/O cards, and so on and so forth, completely through open source software without any proprietary tool such as LabVIEW. In fact, as a replacement for LabVIEW, we are working on a product called GNU Radio. GNU Radio, of course, we have now made GNU Radio to work with Scilab. GNU Radio has very nice hardware, nice graphical features like sliders, knobs, and so on. And I believe that this can replace. This is extremely important because our entire virtual labs project of the mission, which I mentioned earlier, is dependent on LabVIEW, and LabVIEW is a proprietary tool. So this is another thing. So as I mentioned earlier, we would like your participation in all of these. We have a project called Ask a Question. So let me write the website for this. co.learn.in.ask. In fact, this is a 1 hour contact program, 1 hour per week, and it is in this 1 hour session, our faculty members, electrical engineering faculty members, answer questions posed by students in a forum available at this website. More information on how to join this is given here, and I would like you to bring this to the attention of your students who can post conceptual questions. And then maybe during this course itself, there can be more mention of this. It is right now supported by we are doing this only in electrical engineering to start with. We might extend this to other subjects in the future. I think we have already completed 20 plus sessions uninterrupted in this. So I think I would stop here because it's already 9:30. I would like to stop here. There are a few other things like NGSpice, KiCad and things like that that we are working on, but you would actually see them during the course of this 10 days, next 10 days. So I want to congratulate you for participating in this program. In fact, I am really excited by this. I myself plan to attend some of these lectures whenever I have time. I want to wish you all the very best. And as I mentioned earlier, even in this course, which has been planned in a collaborative mode, this Moodle interface will be available at least for one more year. And it is going to be a national resource. And whatever you create now can be used by you. And do please participate. Do ask your questions and grill our faculty members with your questions. And nothing delights the faculty members more than tough questions. Okay, with that, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Kannan. I would just like to correct him by adding that not only you all, but all other teachers and students across the country and in fact across the world would be able to use the contents that get created as a part of this workshop and all such workshops, because all of them are going to be released in open source under the Creative Commons license. That should be an additional incentive for all the participating teachers to contribute significantly during and after this workshop so that we collaboratively increase the accessible knowledge contents for the benefit of all learners across the country. May I request Professor Dinesh Sharma, although he and his colleagues will be engaging with you over the next 10 days, but on this occasion, I would request him to say at least a few words. Professor Sharma.
Welcome to the workshop. I'm sure we'll get to know each other quite well. We are, I have Professor John here and Madam Date. Professor Mahesh Patil will join soon, and we are hoping that we'll persuade Professor Apte, who gave some lectures in the forerunner of this program, to give at least one lecture in the course. He is away and cannot take as many lectures as he did in the forerunner. But as a preamble to this course, I would like to begin first of all by thanking Professor Fatak. We have a small community here of teachers who are passionately interested in enlarging this community and including all teachers outside of the IIT system, outside of the talked about institutions, and worried together about the level of education in our country. And it has taken the vision of Professor Fatak to expand it to a level where we have reached today, so that we have this course and there will be more than 1,000 teachers participating together in this venture. As Professor Kannan pointed out, there are many other means and activities through which we have been trying to reach through to this community, and I am really privileged to know that through these efforts, now we will have a big enough community, and this community is not restricted to a period of 5 or 10 days, that we have a means of communicating with each other, sharing each other's concern, providing solutions to each other over a period of at least 1 year. And that this is a scalable solution, and versions of this for other courses and for other disciplines will surely follow. I think this is the way to go. One of the major bottlenecks to education in a country is the availability of well-trained teachers in large enough numbers. And every effort in this direction is indeed welcome. We must put our shoulders together. And there is no question of being a teacher or a taught in this series of courses. Eventually, we are together shoulder to shoulder in this, and most of the remarks made up to now point to that direction. We would like experts among you to do the lecturing work. We would like you to come up with ideas on which is the best way to go about and train a very large number of teachers in this and many other courses. That done, I would like to now come specifically to this particular course. Basic electronics, as the name implies, is indeed a fundamental and base course in electrical engineering. This is a course that all the teachers that you see here have taught earlier to our first year students, to second year students, not only to electrical engineering students, but in fact to all students who join IIT Bombay. And therefore, it is indeed a pleasure to share the lessons that we have learnt in the teaching of this subject with so many of you. I am sure we will all enrich our experience through discussions with you, because I am sure most of you have also had this experience. The topics included in this course are not the topics, not necessarily the topics that we teach in the IIT Bombay curriculum. In fact, it is a union of the courses taught in your curricula in various universities and centers around India. Therefore, we have assured relevance. The points that we discuss, the labs that we do, and the lectures that we take are indeed the lectures that most of you would be taking in your universities and colleges. So therefore, we are not essentially forcing down your throat a curriculum which may or may not have been relevant to your situation. Indeed, one of the points of discussion would be how to improve the contents of this course and how to make it more uniform. However, this course is not only to teach you about the content, it is to discuss which is the best way to get the material across and how to develop tutorial material which can be of use to a large number of people right across the country. So we have, you have the curriculum of this course with you, and we will, through a series of lectures over the next 10 days, we will take up various topics and we'll have discussion sessions. As Professor Fatak had pointed out, there was a forerunner to this course which was conducted in March, where people from various organizing centers came here in person. We had classes for them in person at that time, and indeed the labs were conducted very enthusiastically, I am very happy to add. Indeed, there were people doing these experiments till late in the evening, well beyond the hours of normal closure of our labs, and I hope to see that same level of involvement and excitement when these labs are conducted at all organizing centers for this course. I am indeed very happy to see the wide acceptance that this course has received. It has encouraged us, it makes all of us feel that our efforts are worthwhile, and it will also motivate us to include other topics in future. Indeed, during this course, there will be a short session in which we will introduce two further courses which will be carried out in this series itself. There is going to be a course on embedded system and another on photovoltaics. So please spread the word around to your colleagues who might be interested in these courses, and there will be an introductory session on these courses later. I think that is about the introduction that I have, and for the closure of this session, I will hand back to Professor Fatak for the concluding comment, and I have comments, and I have a request to our studio technical audience to introduce the support staff as well by a pan across, and to introduce all the people who have made this considerable effort possible through their hard work and through their dedication, getting the network ready, talking to various people, sending all the electronics equipment across, and so on. So I think this will be a good occasion to pan through and to introduce the people who have made it all possible. And I will now hand over to Professor Patel.
Thank you, Professor Sharma. In fact, what Prof. Sharma suggested is the standard part of my thanksgiving at the end of the inaugural function. So, let me begin by thanking my own colleagues from the teams who have been working tirelessly for many months and in fact for many years for similar workshops. Could we have the pan over people, please? So, let me begin by with my managers, Dr. Mukta Atre and Kalpana. Many of you would have received correspondence from them related to this workshop. I have Mr. Sajjan Kumar Dikshit, who is in charge of the video facilities. Sitting in front of him is Mr. Prakash Vaidya, who has been advisor to the project for a variety of things, including contents. We are using the AVIEW tool, which has been developed by Amruta. In fact, Dr. Kamal Bijlani and I have decided to work together to release this entire tool in open source. Currently, by the way, the only non-open source proprietary component used by the tool is a video streaming server, which is used from Adobe. We are trying to replace it by an open source RAID 5 server, and we will soon succeed in that. So, this is my team here. I would also like to thank the colleagues from Electrical Engineering Department who very enthusiastically sponsored the idea of teaching non-computer science, non-theory courses. Virtual labs were mentioned by both Professor Kannan and Professor Sharma, but perhaps this is the right moment to tell you that under the aegis of the virtual labs activities in Electrical Engineering Department, Mrs. Date and her colleagues have done enormous amount of work, and in fact, as we speak, some of the carts are leaving Mumbai physically to reach you in time for the last day of experiment. This is extremely important because this is the first time we are trying this on a large scale, and if this succeeds, we would like to extend it to other disciplines as well. So, Professor Sharma, thank you very much. You and your colleague John Patil is not here. I would like to mention that just teaching core courses is useful but not adequate, because we need expertise in faculty in all courses that are taught in engineering. I am in fact hoping that the government funding will be extended next year to start not only to continue the hub at IIT Bombay, but to start many such hubs at other IITs and NITs, which could actually specialize in specific fields such as mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, and concentrate on conducting such workshops for specific courses, including electives at the higher level. As a part of this program itself, we are trying to make another ambitious activity to be realized next summer. So, let me just take 1 minute to mention it. There is a course on research methodologies and research approach, a very short course which was conducted at IIT Bombay by a colleague professor from IIT Madras, Professor Karmarkar. In fact, our current head of chemical engineering, Professor Sachin Patwardhan, had facilitated that course, and our research scholars found that to be an extremely important foundation course on all aspects of how to begin and continue your research. It not only talks about research methodology, it talks about research motivation, talks about problems that you face. That is not a course which requires a lab. That course requires discussion and some kind of internal working and reporting. So, I am planning to convert it into a 1 week IST workshop. And this workshop, my ambition is that it should reach to 10,000 plus people. So, that is the next level, because practically every researcher, independent of the field in which one is working, would benefit from such a program. And there are teachers amongst us, very large number in fact, who are either pursuing their PhD or wish to pursue their PhD. So, please keep this in mind. The post workshop, there will be a pre-workshop small questionnaire, by the way, which will be administered, which will be put up on the Moodle by today. Please do answer it. Please take about 10-15 minutes to answer that. And we'll be putting up the post-workshop feedback in a similar fashion. The objective of these small questionnaires, apart from the other surveys that would be conducted, is to get a feedback on making these courses better. There are other people who should be thanked. First, P. people from the institute who are missing here, two of my colleagues who head the respective organizations which help in such extended educational programs. One is the head of our continuing education program, Professor Ashok Joshi, and the other is the current head of our Center for Distance Engineering Education Program, Professor Tembe. Both of them and their organizations have been supporting this workshop extensively, and we are grateful. The entire mission project is run under the office of Dean R&D. Professor Rangan Banerjee and Professor Balaji are our Dean R&D and Associate Deans currently, and that office has been extensively helping us. You will realize that about 32 remote centers, 35 remote centers, and 1,000 teachers, and all their monetary transactions involved, handling the budgets, handling the invoices, handling the bills, is not a small affair, and we are helped extensively by these people. And of course, we receive support from all other deans and the director of this institute himself in absolutely all respects, wherever we need anything. Before closing this session, I would like to mention a few names which are very critical, which in fact those people nobody has ever seen in these workshops. One particular person I would like to mention, Mr. Sinha, who has been a dreamer like some of us here, and he is the one whom we can properly call as the architect of the entire national mission project. I think it is only fitting that I express my gratitude to him and his colleagues in the ministry for supporting this idea and for generously funding this project. I would like to end this now, and I think the lecture begins immediately, or is there a break now? Our lecture begins immediately. Thank you so much.